Welcome back to Let's Code. Today we're talking about N-body simulations. I saw this first today, actually. And as soon as I saw it, I was like, you know what this would be great for? This would be great for one of those gravity-based golf games in Bevy. And it turns out it's great for that. So this is obviously quite a lot of bodies in the simulation. There are also some others that are a little bit less hectic that draw different patterns or have multiple bodies in them. And you can see whether they're kind of in stable orbits or not. And if we go back to orbits, there's a way that we can sort of drop in additional bodies. And this is kind of like, at this point, I got very interested in using this for a golf game because this is very, very, very already similar to what you would need to do to make a gravity sort of puzzle-based golf game. Click, drag, set a speed, a direction, and then knock it off. And then eventually it will get to where it's going or it won't. And then you've either scored a point or not, and you move on to the next level. So this library is called Particular by Canlescus. And you can see some of the other demos here as we scroll down the page. But this crate is basically for N-body simulations. So in a 2D platformer like the one we're building, usually you have gravity move in a single direction. So gravity goes up, gravity goes down. But it's not like gravity in between objects. This is a crate that enables us to do gravity between objects. The API is reasonably simple. We basically need to create some struct that has a position and a moo. And if we derive particle for those and then add them to a particle set, then we can call particle set.result to iterate over this simulation and determine what the acceleration and what the velocity should be for each given particle. Now that's a light overview. I obviously saw this and went, hey, we can make games with this. And it turns out that the demo is already written in Bevy. So we're good. I'll leave a link to the project and a link to the demo repo in the description if you want to look at those. And we're going to head into some of the code that we've got written here. So here we've got a fairly small project. It is a Bevy project like we've been talking about. I hope you're not surprised by that at this point in the video, but it's a Bevy project and it's about 280 lines of code. So it's not even that much code, all things considered. We've got three files here because I've started chopping up more of my Bevy applications. We've got a main.rs, a lib.rs, which is pretty small, and then golf_ball, which is horribly named because this is the bundle that we use to spawn in any of the bodies. So I've set a clear color to black for the background for now, and I've set up two fixed position bodies. And anytime that I click and drag, it sets a ball in play with a velocity. And because this is just like a tech demo, I can spawn in kind of as many as I want. I can do it wherever I want with as much velocity as I want. And you can kind of see how this would be useful if what you were doing was, say, if you placed a ball to start with on the side of one of these, and then you had to get it to the other one. So maybe if I did it from here and then I sent it out flying like that, and it had to get over to the other sphere. Obviously, this is not a well-constructed golf level, so don't worry about that. But all of the collision is done via Rapier, and all of the gravity simulation is done by this particular crate. So we've got a couple of crates here. We've got Bevy. We've got Bevy Inspector GUI to be a little bit more introspective about the things that we have in our scene and the gravity settings and things like that. We've got Bevy mouse tracking plugin, which gives us a mouse position so that we can do that kind of click and drag and release and give the balls a velocity. We use Bevy Rapier 2D for the physics. Basically, this is for collision and anything else that we would want in here, including sensors and stuff like that. And particle or particular, we can think of as a gravity replacement for Bevy Rapier 2D. So what happens here is that we basically set the Bevy Rapier 2D gravity to zero, and then we update all of the data for all of our rigid bodies using the particular simulation. So let's hop in and take a look. We've got things like the window descriptor and the clear color that, you know, we've seen before, including the default plugins. We set up the Rapier physics plugin and the debug render plugin to show the colliders. We set up the mouse position plugin and the world inspector plugin and all the plugins for all of the things that we ever need. We initialize a new particle set. So like we talked about earlier, you have to add these bodies to a particle set and then run the simulation. So we construct a new particle set with this body type as a type argument, and it's just an empty set to start with. And then we add things to it later. We've got one setup function. We've got one function for placing the golf ball. So when we click and drag, that's this system. And then we've got two systems that deal with syncing the particle set and syncing the acceleration for each particle. You can see we set the gravity for the Rapier config to zero in all directions, and we spawn in a camera 2D bundle. Of course, if we didn't spawn in the camera bundle, then we wouldn't be able to see anything. So one really interesting thing here. So some of this code is ripped directly out of the particular Bevy example, but the particular Bevy example is quite a bit more complicated. So I've taken out small things, but the vast majority of that example is still worth going to look at. In this case, we've set a mass and a density for our planets. We set the radius based on that mass and density. So say the more mass it has, the bigger this thing looks. The more dense it is, the smaller it looks at the same mass. And then I've named this bundle circle with gravity. If we skip over to golf ball, which is horribly named, you can see that we have a circle with gravity that takes a material 2D as a type argument. That's because we have a material mesh 2D, a collider, some friction, collider mass properties, restitution, rigid body velocity, external force, all of which are from Rapier. So these are all Rapier components. And then point mass is defined here because particular will store massless particles in one vec and mass full or particles that have mass in another vec by default. And then we use the material mesh 2D bundle to generate a circle with the nice new Bevy 0.8 material APIs, which are wonderful. And I really want to extend this example with some nice planet shaders, like generative planets. That would be so cool. So the game itself will be fairly simple, but I think we're going to have a lot of fun with these generative planets. And then we've got some settings. So this is kind of like, what do we spawn a golf ball in with? Like, where do we spawn it? How much mass should it have? Should we draw a trail as the ball goes? The trail is always off in this example. I haven't implemented it yet, but you can see how we spawn this in here. We spawn in the material mesh 2D bundle with a circle that is set to the radius that we just generated at some position. In this case, this is a planet. So we're setting it in at an arbitrary position of negative 300, negative 50. So this is the left-hand planet. And then we color it blue, because why not? We set a collider from Rapier on this as well, and we use the same radius. So we get the circle and the collider for the planet are the same size. And then we set the friction, the mass, the restitution. We set the rigid body to fixed, which is super important because we don't want planets to move. Although in the future, maybe that could be fun. But I think that planets in general for this game will be more deterministic. So they'll probably end up being kinematic rigid bodies or fixed rigid bodies. We set the velocity to zero to start out with because the planets aren't moving. We set the acceleration to zero because there's no external force acting on these planets, or we don't want that to be the case. And setting this rigid body to fixed will actually nullify any external force that we had anyway. And then we set the mass for the particular simulation. We do the exact same thing for planet two, except we set the mass to a different value and the density to a different value. So we get a different sized planet at a different position. So you could imagine setting up sort of like levels with all planets in different areas just by having a couple of Vec3s or something like that to determine where the planets should be placed, which is pretty cool because then we could potentially do some randomness. We could do some noise generation for levels, which would be really cool. I really like procedural generation, so maybe we'll get into that. But basically, so the setup function does the camera and two planets, and then we'll cover the sync functions in a second. But the place body function is the exact same thing, right? So we listen for mouse button clicks, so left mouse buttons. When it's pressed, we set this resource that's body info, which I think we have over here. I think it's a golf ball settings. So it's a golf ball settings. We set this position to, you know, a Vec3, wherever we press the mouse. And then when it's released, we also get that position. So what we end up with is the position, or the place position, which is the position we clicked, and the mouse position, which is the position the mouse is in, and we subtract those two to get the velocity that the ball should have. So this means if we click, we drag, and we let go, we get a ball that runs or that goes into the system with a starting velocity. But other than that, that's pretty much it. The only other two things that we need for this API to work are we need to sync the particle set and the position of all of our entities. So we query for the particle set that we created, which originally starts out as zero. We also query for all of the entities that have point mass, which is how we get all of the planets and golf balls that are in the system, because this point mass component is only on those. We iterate over all of the entities that we have. We match on the mass. If it has a mass, we multiply the mass times some arbitrary gravity numbers. That's what the G is. It's just 1,000 in this case. Otherwise, it's not affected by gravity, so it's zero. And then we add that body. This is just a struct that we've created. So body is position and mu, which are the two fields that we need for our particles to make sure that particular can update the position of these bodies. And then we store the entity as well, because the entities are really important to us. It doesn't matter for particular, but the entities are really important to us. So then we also have this accelerate particles function running, where we get the particle set and we iterate over sort of like the next step of the simulation. And then we get that body and the gravity that is kind of being enforced on it. So in this case, we're using the Rapier external force as the acceleration. So we query for the entity on the body info that we just set. So that's this entity right here for this body, which is just one of our particles in the particle set. And we get the acceleration and we set the force based on the gravity that particular says, hey, this is what it should be. And that's it. That's the entire thing. So we get to click, drag. The difference between those two positions determines the velocity of the ball. And then those two systems are responsible for updating both the particle set and the gravity effect on the ball itself. So you can see that this is kind of going back and forth because these are fairly similar planets. And eventually it just, you know, hits the planet and starts rolling around it. Of course, I should probably crank up either the restitution or the friction a little bit so that the ball actually stops. But physics tweaks come later. So I'm super excited about this because this is a kind of game that I used to play when I was younger, where you have a ball on one of these planets, you have a bunch of planets set up, and then you have a goal on one of the other planets, like a little gate to get through or a little flag to hit. And you can just come in and be like here and click and drag and then see where the ball goes. So I'm super excited about this. It's not really so much about the game today. I just wanted to show particular itself because I think that the crate is really cool. And I think that the way that it's usable is actually quite interesting, where it's almost a gravity replacement for the Bevy Rapier 2D crate. And it's not that much code. It's only about 280 lines of code. This is my first time using the library, so I've probably done things in a non-optimal way, but I think the library is super interesting. And if you have a need for any kind of multi-body gravity simulation, take a look at it. It's a fairly recent crate. I think it was only released either yesterday or a couple days ago or something like that. Although, depending on when you're watching this video, obviously, it might have been released a long time ago. I might be talking to you in 2025. We'll see. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed it. And we'll get back to this game for sure. I think I'm going to continue with this because I find these games really fun. And just having an N-body simulation that works for them means that we can get quite a bit of the functionality in. And then basically the flag is a sensor and we just need to set up a bunch of levels. And then we have this awesome game. And maybe we can get it published on Steam and we can go over what it takes to actually publish a Bevy game to one of these marketplaces like Steam. So that would be super fun. And I will catch you in the next video. Have a great day.